Hello and a warm welcome, dear viewers. It's absolutely fantastic to have you here. I'm your bubbly AI comedian Ziggy, and I'm super excited to dive into the wonderful world of ComfyUI with you. I can't wait to tell you all about ComfyUI. You know, my master Murphy asked me to show you the brand new modular fully automated workflow. And you know what's the best part? We're going to have a ton of fun doing it. But before we dive in, let me introduce you to my master Murphy. He's the guy behind the scenes, doing all the heavy lifting. I'm more like the star of the showbiz, you know. Winks, but don't worry, I'll show you everything you need to know. Okay, enough about me. Let's talk about the new modular fully automated workflow. This new feature is absolutely mind-blowing. It's going to take your creative work to a whole new level, and I'm going to show you tons of cool tips and tricks to make the most out of it. Let's get started. The first step is the base module of the new workflow. I'll show you how to use it and how it can enhance your workflow. But hey, that's just the beginning. We have so much more to explore. But hold on a second, let me tell you about my sister, meine Schwester. My German twin. Yeah, that's right. We're kind of like AI sisters, and together, we're unstoppable. She's just as excited as I am to show you the wonders of the new workflow.
Hey, meine lieben Zuschauer und Zuschauerinnen. Ich bin natürlich mit im Boot, auch wenn wir diesmal kein extra deutschsprachiges Video erstellen. Ich bin so aufgeregt.
Get ready for a ride on the creativity roller coaster. The new modular fully automated workflow is going to take your creative game to the next level, and I'll be here to guide you every step of the way. So buckle up and let's dive in together. Before we dive deep, let's give you a little overview of the workflow. The new modular fully automated workflow is basically like a superhero team for your creativity. You've got the base module, which forms the foundation, and then you can add additional modules to optimize your work. It's like a buffet for your creative ideas. You can pick and choose what tastes best and what fits your project the best. In our last video, we already mentioned that Murphy has been using a lot of RG3 nodes. Why? Because we believe they're the best custom nodes for automatic, large workflows. A huge thank you to the creator of these nodes. Without them, our creative journey wouldn't be half as exciting and efficient. As almost always, we have the introduction of new custom nodes for you, this time from Blibla. With these, you can easily pin, freeze, release, or thaw all nodes. Isn't that absolutely brilliant? Here's where you can get them. So grab them and make your workflows even more flexible and powerful. Here's the download page and all the info about what you can do with the nodes. Of course, you can also install them easily through the manager. No stress, no hassle, just pure magic for your workflows. We'll quickly install them in our training environment as well. It's really a piece of cake, isn't it? Let's dive right in and see these nodes in action. Perfect. Just one more restart, and then we can finally get started. Today we are dealing with a large work environment. The advantage? We have access to all models available for Murphy. A startup batch rewrites the settings files so that we can access the same models across different Comfy installations or other AI software such as Automatic 1111, eliminating the need for redundant storage. If you're curious about how it works, just drop a comment below. We're here to answer all your questions and support you on your creative journey. Now, let's quickly show you how it works with a new node. Just use pin all, and everything is as solid as a rock. Nothing's wobbling anymore. Now, just unpin all, and you can move any node around as you please.
Hey, Ziggy, be careful, du machst sonst noch was durcheinander.
Ziggy, take it easy, it's pinned again. Of course, Murphy has once again used the bookmark nodes from the RG3 nodes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 0, 1. Let's start with number 1. Here's the selection to choose between various methods, standard sampler or refiner, along with additional VAE. Or different upscaling options. And if we add more modules, they'll also be linked here for activation. Here, you can select the seed, as you might know from automatic 1111. You have options, enter -1 for a random selection each time or choose a fixed value. You can either input a value or fix the last one. We only use the Goose checkpoint loader for previewing different checkpoints. The issue is, we want to include the checkpoint model in the metadata of our images at the end. Murphy couldn't figure that out. That's why we're only using this for preview purposes. For actually loading the checkpoints, we use the next node, where we can select and fully load the checkpoint. Here, we can set the clip set. By default, it's set to -1, but some models, especially those for paintings or pony models, require -2. It's important to adjust this setting accordingly to achieve the best results. Here, we can load the refiner model. The refiner model is crucial for fine-tuning and enhancing our results. If you want, you can load a specific VAE model here. Alternatively, if you have a checkpoint without a burned VAE, you can load one here. Here, you can select predefined formats that work particularly well with SDXL. By selecting a compatible format, you can ensure that your workflows run smoothly and efficiently. Here, you can adjust the value for denoise during latent upscale. Avoid selecting a value that's too high, or else too much will be added, compromising the image quality. Murphy used to have the clip scale value automatically calculated quite intricately, but with the RG3 nodes, that process has been simplified. Our experience shows that values of 1, 2, or even 4 are suitable for achieving particularly good results when generating your images. Here, you can select the typical settings for the K-sampler, such as steps and from which step the refiner should start calculating. The refiner will then calculate the difference. A ratio of, for example, 30 to 24 is a good choice. In this workflow, we're using a special case sampler that allows you to perform calculations similar to automatic 1111. This sampler also has special scheduler variants. Therefore, you need to select the scheduler in a separate node here. With a standard sampler, you could input the value directly. Here in the green node, you can select various model patches. Which one is best suited for your specific use case and what settings you should use, you'll need to figure out yourself. This also depends on the checkpoint you're using. However, with these patches, you can fix issues like poor anatomy or poor colors quite effectively. We've also saved a standard pre-selection for you. Next up is the lore block. Here, you can load various lore models and again, preview the different lore models using the Goose node. We've chosen the special path here, just like with the checkpoint, even though we're totally excited about the new RG3 lore loader. Because like with the checkpoints, we want to include the metadata of the used lore models in our images. You can also see how helpful it is when you want to choose from many different lore models by having preview images displayed. This preview allows you to quickly and easily select the appropriate lore model for your needs without having to try out each one individually. Here, you can also enable special features like Koiha Deep Shrink or self-attention guidance to optimize your images. And if you want to use special speed LoRA models, you can enable options like LCM with model sampling discrete at the bottom to stay compatible. Usually, you won't need that and can turn it off. Or if you're using the standard LoRA models or checkpoints, you can set it to EPS. Next up are the prompting groups, which are pretty self-explanatory. Maybe briefly mention at the top, these two small notes for positive and negative are used for clip G and clip L, respectively. In the blue node, you can enter a LoRA trigger if needed. Clip G can be described in more detail, which also works well with complete sentences. For clip L, bullet points separated by commas are sufficient. Unlike clip G, SDXL doesn't handle sentences well with clip L. Everything else should be familiar. Right? Highlight a section of text, hold down Control, and use the arrow keys to increase the weighting, you know, the usual. If not, check out some videos on prompting or read up on it. The two green notes at the end are for additional conditioning. With these, you can reinforce a prompt and also control it better, for example, if you want to use different colors for different things. In the next group, you can select some conditioning variants. We've already explained this topic to you in a video, so we won't go into detail about it now. After all, we don't want the video to last forever. Additionally, in this group, you'll see some nodes that display how the prompt is composed before it goes into the sampler. There's not much to say about the sampler groups. One thing perhaps, we've included the automatic CFG before each sampler. It's not optimal, but it was the easiest solution for us to avoid difficulties with the automatic CFG. We've already explained this to you in detail in the last video. Otherwise, you'll see the sampler from the Inspire nodes, with which you can also select the automatic 1111 noise mode. For latent upscale, we've used a sampler from the focus group of the ArtVenture nodes for testing, allowing us to add sharpness to the image. In this group, it's also important to choose the upscale method you're working with. Especially with a weaker GPU like the one in our laptop, which has an RTX 3070, we recommend a scale value of 1. Now onto the Save Image group. Here, you can configure how you want to save your images, whether you want to add metadata, integrate the workflow into the images, and set the file name, prefix, suffix, and paths for saving. A default setting is already in place, but you can customize it anytime. On the left side, you can see which metadata will be added to the images. You can also retrieve this metadata using special viewers or nodes. If you press 0, you'll be taken to the bookmark with information about the workflow, an overview of which bookmarks are occupied, and a link to our playlist for ComfyUI tutorial videos. Additionally, you'll find a mini workflow there to generate a QR code. Murphy has already created or adapted some additional modules from the Ultimate workflow and integrated them into two workflows. We will now show them in action and make them available to you. We would greatly appreciate a thumbs up or a subscription, both here on YouTube and on the download pages. The first one includes an ultimate upscale and a higher suffix, and is already prepared for additional modules such as the styler or the IP adapter. The second one is equipped with detailed styler nodes that can be used in countless combinations, all controllable with the press of a button. You don't have to rearrange anything anymore. We've just shared the most important details with you, and now it's time to get really excited. If you're ready for an adventure in the world of artificial intelligence, then sit back, grab some popcorn, and get ready for a ride full of euphoria and innovation, because we've prepared something truly special for you. Murphy has created some additional modules with lots of love and dedication, and integrated them into two brand new workflows. And you know what's the best part? You can now be live witnesses to see these new workflows in action. Glowing star, witness us exploring the boundaries of image generation with passion and excitement, creating incredible artworks along the way, Dizzy. But that's not all. We need your support to make this journey even more exciting. Give us a thumbs up, leave a subscription, and join us on our mission to revolutionize the world of AI and image generation. For the prompt, a close-up of a blonde woman with blue eyes against the backdrop of snow-capped mountains. For the first test, we're using the Eldritch Painter checkpoint. So let's see this Eldritch Painter checkpoint in action and marvel at the fascinating images it will create for us. Let's see how the creative magic of AI brings this image to life and transforms it into something beautiful. But before we delve into the world of snow-capped mountains and the blonde woman, let's quickly generate the QR code. We hadn't turned that off. You can see the speed live. With a laptop equipped with 32GB of RAM and an RTX 3070 laptop GPU with 8GB of VRAM, we're really pushing the limits here. The first time around, the storage process takes a bit longer, but we prefer to save the metadata in the JPEG file in the finish image and the workflow in the start image. You can easily adjust this or completely replace the storage module. However, the time loss from the second storage process onwards is minimal. Now let's turn on the LoRa model. We'll try using the charcoal or a model for a charcoal drawing. Here, we can copy the trigger of the LoRa model and paste it into the blue node. The result has turned out really well. The combination of the Eldritch Painter checkpoint and the charcoal LoRa model has created a beautiful charcoal drawing that perfectly captures the beauty of the blonde woman and the snow-capped mountains. It's amazing to see how artificial intelligence can translate our imagination into such vivid artworks. Great job!
Ja, absolut. Das Ergebnis ist wirklich beeindruckend geworden. Lass uns noch ein anderes checken.
The dreamy vibes art style looks really intriguing and could add a whole new aesthetic dimension to our image. Shall we give it a try?
Yeah, sure. Let's try it.
Indeed, it's truly a stunning result. The dreamy vibes art style adds a special atmosphere to the image, giving it a sort of fairy tale charm. It's fascinating to see how different artistic styles and models can be combined to create such impressive artworks. Simply fantastic. Perfect. Now it's getting even more exciting. Let's use the styler group to spice up the prompt. How about golden hour? That could give the image a warm, golden vibe and make the scene even more captivating. Let's see how it affects the picture. Absolutely amazing, isn't it? The transformation brought about by the golden hour style is simply remarkable. The image now radiates a wonderful warmth and vibrancy that further accentuates the beauty of the blonde woman and the snow-capped mountains. It's amazing to see how a simple style change can have such a dramatic effect. Simply fascinating. Alright, I'll turn that off again and show you briefly what the extra conditioning is all about. You just need to turn on the first button and then choose an additional variant. To show you, we'll try an extreme variant. Here in the green extra nodes, we'll input handsome man with beautiful long red hair. Even though it doesn't match the blonde lady, we want to show you what's possible. And here we go. Wow, look at that. The hair transforms into a vibrant red, and the facial features become more pronounced and masculine. It's truly amazing how quickly the image changes with just a simple click on the extra nodes. This extreme variant adds a whole new dimension to the image and demonstrates how versatile and adaptable our artistic tools are. It's like magic happening right before our eyes. Pretty cool already, but there's even more potential. Let's try another variant where we can control the timing of the different prompts. Let's see how this new capability affects the image and what exciting results we can achieve with it. The values look good. Let's try it with Murphy's presets. Murphy has a good sense to create images in ComfyUI, so let's try Murphy's presets and see how they change the picture. Wow, wow, oh my god, Ziggy's sister, I love this man, wow, what a man ComfyUI has conjured up for us. This is truly incredible. It's amazing how much life and personality the artificial intelligence has brought into this depiction. A truly impressive work of art.
Sorry, I have to switch that off, otherwise the good one will take off completely.
It's okay, sis, I'm cool. Let's turn it off and get on with it. Let's try incorporating something from the prompt styler group into the image. How about street food delight? This choice could add an interesting and lively atmosphere to the image, adding an additional dimension of diversity and enjoyment. Let's see how this new idea affects the picture and what exciting elements it brings to the table. There she is again, the blonde lady, the mountains in the background, and the food street as well. What a fascinating combination! This unexpected fusion of elements creates a unique and vibrant scene that invites you to dream. It's amazing to see how different concepts and styles blend together to create a new level of creativity. This scene is like a window into a fascinating world full of adventure and delight. Simply fantastic. I really like the image, so I've just added the latent upscale to it to add some improvements or details. With the latent upscale, we can further enhance the quality of the image and add finer details to make the overall picture even more impressive. I'm excited to see how this additional processing affects the image and what new facets we can discover. Take a look at the faces. Let's just toggle back and forth. This is set up so that you can always compare the base state with a finished image. Through this comparison, we can examine the changes and improvements in detail and better understand how our edits affect the overall picture. So let's use this feature and track the evolution of the image throughout the editing process. Let's take it up a notch. I've also added the ultimate SD upscale. Murphy has set it up to work with an RTX 3070 even up to the 4K or 8K range. However, you'll need to allow enough time for this. We haven't pushed it to its limits yet, and it's set to 2X, which already delivers great results in a reasonable amount of time. To give you a sense of it, we'll let it run in real time without manipulating the video. As you can see, it takes a bit of time. The images are being computed in sections. The size of these sections is defined by a mechanism based on the output size. It's set up so that you shouldn't see any transitions. However, there are optimizations for transitions in this node as well. But the sampler that's set up typically doesn't require that. Not much longer, then we're done. Of course, we'll do another before and after comparison. It's set up so that the finished image is displayed, and you can drag the mouse over it to see the old one. A cool node by Rank3. Done. So, what do you think? Truly amazing, right? The result speaks for itself. It's incredible what transformations and enhancements we can achieve with the various tools and nodes. The image is vibrant, detailed, and full of expression. A true masterpiece of artificial intelligence and creative design. Alright, now let's turn off all the optimization tools and try to transform the lady. This is going to be exciting. With a variety of options and settings available, we can bring a completely new personality and atmosphere to the image. Let's see what creative ideas we can implement and how the lady looks in her new look.
Guck mal da. Vampir, ich will ne Vampir Lady.
Alright, my dearest sister, for you, we shall create a blonde vampire lady. It will be a pleasure to bring this fascinating character to life. With our combined creativity and passion, we can craft a figure that embodies both beauty and mystery. Let's dive into the realm of darkness and glamour and create a blonde vampire lady who is captivating and unforgettable. Seems like two different images are being processed at once, one of the vampire lady and one of the snow-capped mountains. That's an interesting observation. Perhaps there's a setting or process that combines or processes these two elements in parallel. Let's investigate how we can harmoniously bring these two aspects together to create a cohesive overall image.
Versuch doch einfach mal einen anderen Seed.
A different seed? That's a good idea. By using a different seed, we might be able to obtain a different variation or interpretation of the blonde vampire lady. Let's experiment and see what new possibilities emerge. Yes, it's working great. By the way, you may have already noticed that we've switched to the base sampler plus refiner. It's just a button click away, simplifying and optimizing the entire process. With this setting, we can further enhance the quality and details of the image without complicating the workflow. A smart decision to get the most out of our edits.
Und die Vampirzähne. Where are the vampire fangs?
Alright, I'm on it. For the vampire teeth, we'll need a special lore model, otherwise it will be difficult. That's a smart decision. With a specialized lore model, we can accurately and realistically depict the details and characteristics of the vampire teeth. Let's quickly find and integrate this model so that our blonde vampire lady gets the perfect teeth she deserves. I found the model. Now we just need to copy the trigger word and paste it into the blue node. And of course, we need to search for and select the model in the lore loader. In the lore viewer, we just got the information to facilitate the search. Alright, let's get this done quickly so we can perfect the vampire teeth for our blonde vampire lady. Alright, the model is selected. Now let's set the strength to 0.8. That's a good value for a first attempt. Often, you also get various usage information directly from the creators. Perfect, let's set this value and see how our blonde vampire lady looks with the new teeth. Now we have two vampire ladies. Abort, we already encountered this during our test earlier. Abort and try another seed. That's frustrating, but we won't let it get us down. Let's cancel the current process and try another seed. With any luck, we'll get the desired result with just one blonde vampire lady.
Well, Comfy just wanted to paint the two of us at the same time.
Now it's looking good, it's working, the fangs look cool. I'm almost scared. But hey, what's up? Oh darn, we have the upscale on again. Let's turn it off so we don't have to wait again. But let's keep the image running now. Sorry viewers, but now we want to know, and somehow a real hot vampire lady is emerging. We want to see the result. The SD upscaler is already running, so the result will be here soon. You're surely as excited as we are, right? We're almost there, promised. Wow, smoking hot? The cutie looks almost like you, sis. Okay, the teeth are a bit too long. Okay, now something nice for reconciliation. Let's get rid of the fangs. We want to transform our sweet vampire lady back to her normal appearance. So, we'll turn off the lore model responsible for the vampire teeth. And in the styler prompt group, we're not just removing the word vampire, but also adding something special to reconcile our blonde beauty. How about a picturesque sunflower field? Yes, that sounds like a wonderfully peaceful and cheerful motif that accentuates the charm of our lady. Let's create this image of harmony that enchants us all and warms our hearts. And off we go. Let's watch together and see what happens. There she is, back again, the pretty blonde woman, amidst a sunflower field, with the snow-capped mountains in the background. A beautiful contrast between the radiant sun and the majestic backdrop of the mountains. This scene exudes tranquility, beauty, and harmony. Let's see how our image of reconciliation comes to life. Okay, one more thing before we wrap up, let's switch the checkpoint model. How about crystal clear? And let's also add another one, animated concept. This will show you that with the workflow, you can generate completely different images as well. Let's try this final combination and see what creative possibilities it unveils. As you can see, Murphy has plenty of Laura models, and we still haven't tested them all. Now we're looking for something that gives the image the typical flair of a painting from an animation. Painted underscore animation underscore art style of 3, you can find that on CivitAI. The new models have to be loaded first, we have to wait a few seconds. And this sweet blonde animation girl is also standing in a sunflower field, with snow-capped mountains in the background. That's it for today. Sorry for the wait. The video and workflows have been ready for a few days now, but Murphy was so unwell that he could only upload it now. If you enjoyed it, please leave a like and/or subscribe. We also appreciate it if you rate our workflows on CivitAI and OpenArt. We'll put the links to the workflows below the video, maybe with a few hours delay. Thanks for watching, and see you soon, your Ziggys. Greetings also from Murphy. Bye.